habit tracking widget app, a task management system with goals, and also a brand new way to manage your workspace with AI. Today, we're going to dive into three new apps in our brand new series. So let's dive in. Welcome everyone, if you're brand new, my name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome to Toolfinder. This is a brand new series to dive into new and noteworthy tools, and we're gonna release three every single week. So if you do wanna tune in every single week to this episode, then you can subscribe today and get it in your YouTube inbox. However, if you don't want, or you don't wanna miss it, or you just don't wanna watch me, that's totally fine, I won't take offense. You can join the email newsletter below and I will email you three new apps every week that are in that video. So you can find all those descriptions below. This video today is brought to you by AccuFlow. Thank you to AccuFlow for sponsoring. You can check them out below. The first app on our list is called Did I Do? And it's a simple habit tracking app, which is designed with iOS widgets in mind. I really like the concept of this app because what it does is it puts your widget first and foremost on your screen. So you can see whether you've done a habit or not. And that puts pressure on you because you open your home screen every single day and see that no indicating on there. So this is a great way to tick off a habit instead of missing it every single day, forgetting that you're in the app. Obviously, there's a premium with notifications, things like that, but the app is generally free to get access to and start using, and it uses the widgets straight away, which you could set up with a certain task that you've got, but there are limits to how many tasks or habits that you can add to the experience, which is expected in a free version. But they are planning to add the ability to share it with somebody else, so you can see whether the other person has done it or not, which is quite nice. And there's also a feature in it where you can share a photo to prove that you've done it, which is pretty cool. Accountability type of thing. But the app is free to use and it's a very cool tool and one that we're very impressed with so far. Our second app on the list is called Fabric. Now this one is a workspace that basically takes all of your notes, ideas, and even uploads from, you know, like files and links and voice memos, everything you're capturing across a typical day into a workspace for you to search and bring together. There's similar apps like this, like My Mind, which is quite similar, but this one has a desktop app. It's also AI focused, both of those. My Mind also does something similar, but this one is much more workspace focused, allowing you to connect integrations up as well. So Fabric is an interesting tool and it has a really attractive Mac and Windows app that give you a really nice experience for desktop. Now the AI search is actually part of their premium experience, but it does have some chatbot abilities in the app as part of that. And it also has the ability to upload voice memos as well as some extensions for the browser too. So an interesting tool for the future of capturing ideas as you go across your day. Now, the final tool is called Gripply, and it's an interesting task management app. I normally see these apps, I'm like, ah, it's another task management app. So you can do certain things with a task management app, but this one does it quite nicely because it's a little bit like TimeStripe in a way. It has goals and habits in it, but you can track goals and see your visions for each of the things you're working on. So I quite like that. They're sort of like mini pages combined with habit tracking and a goal tracker. So you can set a project in mind and tick items off and work towards it. I like that. It's something that I like in Things 3, but this app does it a lot more structured in the mindset of goals, which I quite like. So it's worth checking out if you want to have a process-oriented task management application in 2025. So those were my three apps. And as I said, you can subscribe and check out more of these. Always find the best ones for you. I'll create them myself. I think if you want them just in my inbox, that's totally fine too. You can have both. I can badge you on both if you want. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed this episode. As normal, you can jump over to Toolfinder to find any AI tools at toolfinder.co to explore more. So thanks so much. Make sure and have a great week. And I hope the train of 2025 continues. And I'll speak to you soon. Cheerio.